Composition Using Beer Cans by Doris Charest. What we're going to do is analyze the design of this beer can and see if it can be used in our compositions, in our paintings. These are brilliant designs and they're made so we can learn from them. So we start with a stripe and then the design that leads to the focal point. The focal point is the horse. And then the text underneath. And if you notice, the text is light against dark, dark against light. At the bottom, it's yellow. And then these colors are repeated. They're repeated in the text, and they're repeated where the horse is. Now, the horse is white, but it has touches of yellow and touches of teal, which is another color in the design. So we have three basic colors. We have yellow, we have purple, we have teal, and then we have the black and the white. These colors are all arranged so that our eye leads to the focal point. The focal point being the horse, but also the name of the beer. All around, the darks are around the light areas. So here we have yellow that leads to dark, that leads to light, that leads to more white, that is surrounded by yellows and darks, which is the horse, that leads to the logo or the name of the beer, which is in a different color, and then yellow and then more purple. These stripes lead our eye around to the horse, to the unicorn, and also lead our eye to the brand of the beer. Now there are also stripes at the top, and that's to bring your eye down as well, down to the logo. But at the same time, it might make the can look bigger. So you might think there's more beer in there than a regular can. That's smart design. Now what can we take away here? We have the trees in the background that lead our eye up. We have angles that lead our eye towards the focal point, the big tree, light areas against dark areas, purples, yellows, and blues. And these work really well together. These are great color combinations. Here you have lines that lead to the focal point. You have light areas against dark areas, and they all lead to the focal point. The highest area of contrast is near the tree, which is the focal point. These are lessons just like the beer can. So our basic takeaway is have high contrast, lines that lead your eye towards the focal point. So that's it for now. Try this in your own painting, and we'll see you in the next composition analysis.